Hi people, Punky here, welcome back to this channel. In this episode we're doing review for Panzerjäger 1 German Tier 2 tank destroyer, and we'll do this review from two main parts. First this shot in garage part, then three fantastic games in this tank, one mine, one random live game, and one of your best games in this tank. So let's start with appearance of this tank. You know, it is ugly in my opinion. Too narrow, too tall, you know, and let's compare it with benchmark for size on this channel, my Red T-34, just to see and grasp better size of this tank destroyer. So it is very, very narrow, like you can see. So that will help you, you know, to be smaller target. But what about firepower on this tank? You have two guns in selection, one 3.7cm Puck L-47. Not a bad gun, you know, but Alpha is small, so you want to use this 4.7cm L43 gun, 24 rounds per minute rate of fire, 62mm of penetration with this standard AP rounds, 115 with gold APCR rounds. That is pretty good, you know. Don't use HE shells on guns below 75mm in caliber. Alpha damage is 60 HP, accuracy 0.35 more on 100 meters. I must say, you have feeling that accuracy is worse even with this good crew. Aiming time is 1.7 seconds. It is not bad, you know, but you still want to use gun lane drive, trust me. So what about armor on this tank? You have 13mm all around. It is crap armor, we will not waste any more time on that. Let's see something about driving this tank. It has 40 km/h forward top speed, not bad. It is fast actually, but in reverse just 8 km, you know, it is painfully slow. And you know, if they put at least 12 km/h, that wouldn't hurt balance of this tank. So you mostly want to snipe with this tank, but sometimes you will wish to go forward and to do more damage, you know, when game is toward the end, and that speed will help you. So what about equipment, ammo, and these grills? Well, using binoculars for extended view range, gun length drive for even faster aiming, trust me, you need that. And come on it, because you are a sniper, you want to be, you know, in concealment longer. Ammo, you don't need to carry full load of this ammo, you know, 77 rounds of AP will be enough, 7 rounds of APCR or more, if you can afford that, will be just cool. So what about those grills now? Well, I have 4.5 set of skills and perks on them. You know, soon I will transfer them in some other vehicle. So we have Brothers in Arms, that was gift, Sixth Sense, that was, you know, gift with this crew. Then we have Concealment, Recon, Mentor for Commander. Then here, Designated Target, Armorer, Concealment, Dead Eye. You know, maybe Armorer isn't very good, you know, choice for this small gun, but okay. So here we have Smooth Ride, Concealment, Off-Road Driving, Clutch Braking. I should choose first, you know, Clutch Braking instead of Smooth Ride, and Smooth Ride in the end, but okay. One day in a thousand years we will research that last set of skills and perks, so it will be okay. So now let's see that awesome gameplay. Okay, so our first game here on Abbey map, you know. And let's see, we are in platoon with Washer Dryer and Yellow Canary. It is tier 2 match, luckily. And let's see what will happen. A lot of pushing. What the hell those tanks doing? Why are they doing that? I don't know. But let's see this tank in action. We'll go in this position. So back in my view. So do you see this like pyramid shaped rock? There you want to position yourself. Oh, that is T2 medium. Fairly big target, you know. Well, all American tanks are giant, you know. Nice targets. Well, most of them. That tier 7 light tank, what is the name? T-70 or something. That one is smaller. Okay, Washer doing some spotting there. T2 medium once more. Wow. Well, he didn't have any better idea. I think his engine is damaged and he's knockout. So let's see, we spotted that MKA. Shoot for gold, you know. Gold runs are for gold tanks. And now he spotted the me, you know. So we need to go in cover. There is RT in game also. And actually, that SU-18, if it is close, can shoot me even there. So we need to be very close to the, you know, cover. A rock or a building, whatever. So now I went here to see, do I have targets? Oh, I still have shot on that MKA. If he stay there, well, cruiser got him, you know. And I think, okay, it is very bad on that side. And anyway, this tank isn't really good for fighting left there, because this short area, you know, they will easily pen you everywhere and shoot you in this, you know, gun shield. So I went here, but Washer Dryer actually moved away from that monastery. I was hoping that he will stay there, and now he is spotted. And actually, I cannot help him now. So we'll stay here and try to stop onslaught on this position, because if we lose this side, well, it is like a game over for us, you know. If we lose left side, well, we can still fight from this position, you know, and defend base. But if you lose this side and they attack from other side, well, we are in sandwich. Very bad, nasty tasting sandwich. So there you go, a Tetra killed the Washer. You know, he was hiding in that indentation, you know. And here I am in very good position, you know, but because of that rock, I cannot do anything against that Tetrarch until he, you know, proceeds forward. And there he is. T-60, what T-60 doing? T-60 is AFK. Cruiser rushing directly on him. Maybe a headshot there, but I don't have any more. Artillery is missing, so this was pretty tense, you know, in this moment. And there you go, Panzer 35T killed cruiser. T is for Czechoslovakia, you know. Way how Germans write Czechoslovakia. No, Czechoslovakia. I don't know how they're pronouncing that, actually. Why are you even trying? But it is with T. Czechoslovakia. Okay. So we knock out that tree, so we would be, you know, in cover. I mean, we would have better concealment. And now that is a Y type B. Very good tank with the pom-pom gun, you know. I really enjoyed driving that little tank with a pom-pom gun. I had some of my best games with that. So, you see, he's still there. There is no splash, you know. There you go, one splash. But there, no. So, I still hitting, you know. And there he is. I gave up and then the last shot actually killed him. Because there is more targets here that need to be killed, you know. Okay, what is that? Is that MKA? No. It is T-45. T-45 wasn't one who spotted me, I think. Probably it was that Panzer 35T in bush. And luckily he didn't do a lot of hurt to me and my crew. Because they are girls, you know. This game. And now it is, you know, better. We can breed now. Okay, this dude was, you know, focusing on one target too much, and despite all that armor, firepower and hit points, he's dead, you know. He managed to put one in us, but we counted with that. So now it is even, you know. So 3-3, you know. And I'm hoping that Panzer 35T will try to push again in same bush, and now I can spot him and he's one shot, you know. If I spot him from here, I will kill him, you know, before he even spots me. Hopefully BT2 will stay in cover, but we don't have shot. He is behind that rock. No shots on BT2, but my team, you know, doing a very good job against that BT2. I fired one blind, maybe it was too high, but both of those shots, you know, you saw splash, meaning we are not hitting anything. So there you go, he is running away in a town, you know, in a settlement, and that is okay, you know, because this TD is decently fast. So we will follow him. This is risky, you know. It can happen that, you know, he will kill me. Something wrong will happen. Maybe I will flip again. Well, you will see what I mean, because I recorded that live game prior to this one. You know, or maybe he will get lucky and unlock me, you know. Many things can happen, or he can be behind me in any moment now. And while I turn, you know, auto gun, he can get me. But I wanted to kill six tanks for this, you know, review. So I was risking, you know. Who risks wins, how that boy says. So he's not here. I wanted to check this just in case. There is some crazy people, you know, who playing. You cannot get in their mind, so you need to be extra cautious, you know. So my team is progressing. Even H35 is in front of me now, Mini Matilda. And there is Arty, and there is Panzer 35T spotted, but I thinking, okay, he is moving and Arty doesn't moving. I am not trying to knock out this fence because, you know, I hoping it will protect me from that Arty. And how that shot didn't clutch him, I don't know. I fired there, just you didn't hear because of my voice and fire of that autogun. And now, oh, I'm in a really bad situation. So did you saw that tiny shot? And Panzerjäger 1 with a German accuracy and precision, you know. I managed to put that shot in so small portion of his armor and to kill him for 7 kills. So I wanted 6 kills for you guys, but you got 7 kills in Panzerjäger 1, you know. So let's see post game data and then one live random game. Okay, so we earned 4000 credits, 53 shots fired, 35 on target, not bad. Accuracy could be better, 9 tanks damage, didn't kill 7, you know. And let's see team score, settlement experience, first in that with 844 stars of experience, 7 kills first in that by far, and 1663 HP of damage first in that in both teams. 3 tanks spotted, top gun, high caliber, 4 perfect duelist, bruiser, and M badge for this tank and this game. So let's see a random live game. Okay, time for one random battle with live commentary. And hopefully we will see some new moments with this TD. Also, you will grasp this tank and what I'm doing better, because I will, you know, say everything what I do. Also for new guys, you know, you can copy my positions and what I'm doing, you know, remember that well, so you can do well until you develop your own style. It is great map, you know, for this TD. It is Hills, Mines, Rudnik, I don't know how you're calling this map. Tier 3 match? Okay. But this map is, you know, very good for this TD, especially that other side. I would go on K 5, or between K 4 and K 5, on that position near rock in bush. But here, we'll go up here. Little bit to the right. We'll knock out this tree, and we'll sit just here. In the bottom of that. Okay, are they going up? Oh, that was just too slow. Where is that dude? Oh, come on. Okay. Okay, wow, that is what we're talking about, 0.35 more accuracy. And this is why I selected, you know, gun laying dive for this tank, despite having pretty good aiming time, you know, because sometimes you will need to do those clutch shots. The Germans are not, you know, very good for clutch shooting. So this tank also TD, and that is why you want as much help for that as possible, you know. And you saw how fast they are, you know. And now we will just you know, stay here and we'll try to hit tanks. Will they kill that BT-5? Yes. Okay, so now I think I have a feeling that we will flip. Oh my god. Help! Well, let's try. FCM, I am flipped. Please help. Guy, dude. Thanks. But they finishing that dude's pretty good, you know. Our team was great, you know. When I was, you know, preparing for this review, you will not believe me. But trust me. Whenever I start this game, it will send me on EU2. And I lost 3 games in a row, you know, doing almost nothing because my team didn't want to deploy, you know. Oh, thank you, buddy, you are so kind. You always need to turn toward him and to press forward, you know, in order to get on your feet faster. Thank you, you will be on YouTube. So that is that, they killed everything. And we started good, you know, until we didn't. Then we crumbled down. And well, let's see, maybe there is still hope for two of us to do something, you know. But no. Okay, time for random live game with live commentary, and hopefully we'll do better than previous game. but maybe we'll flip again, just for fun. So, let's see what we'll get this time. That map is good, I like that map, you know, just other side is much better, so hopefully we can get that one. Oh no, it is Abbey map, you know. Tier 3 match again. Some crazy tanks in game. And let's see, can we do something here? A lot of fast tanks these days, you know. This tank doesn't like fast tanks. That is why you want that gun laying drive if you want to keep this tank, you know. If you just, you know, playing this tank until you unlock next one, well, don't invest in gun laying drive, because then you need to pay 10 gold coins to remove it, you know, and to save it. If you just remove it without gold, it will destroy it, you know, and you wasted 500,000 silver rubles. Yeah, also well, I wanted to say something really good, I can feel it, you know, but I forgot now. You're talking, yeah, you can buy them when they are on discount, you know. From time to time you will find them for 250,000 rubles, and then that is much better. Oh no, so that is accuracy of 0.35 more. Yep, fully aimed. Well, I thought that will miss too. And that one too. But I guess didn't. Okay. So, yeah, I said this is not, you know, that feeling of 0.35 more accuracy. So, whoa, why we didn't do damage there? Why? Oh, did you chuck it now? Oh, let's hope that we did. Oh, that is so lovely jubbly. So lovely jubbly there. So, sometimes you will have a lot of jub here, you know, and sometimes not really. Oh, we rushed that shot. So, oh, too late for us to go now there to intercept MKA. But we can make ambush here. So let's do it. Oops. Well, it is a really slim tree, we should leave it, you know, there. But let's see. Should be able to spot him on my own, you know. We are leading 4-2. Artillery, what are you doing? Hopefully he is not going, you know, to the bush. But I should be able to spot him even if he's going there, you know. Where is he? It's taking too long, you know. My teammates. Ooh. Sneaky blaster, you know. My teammates can lose until he show himself. Oh, there he is. Oh yeah, waiting for bush. Oh yeah, stay in bush. Oh yeah, that's it. Oh, that was so nice. Mm-hmm-hmm. So, now it is question where to go, you know. Where to go and who to support, you know. They have Valentine there, can I shoot something in city, you know. That is why I'm going back. Maybe I can shoot something. Nope. Okay. But I have feeling that I will have more targets if I go there. In that village city. Well, it is not city. For sure. In that... how you say that? Settlement. Settlement, yeah. Okay, that is what with which you cannot, you know, do wrong. Settlement. City is settlement, village is settlement, town is settlement. Few tents is settlement. This tank is settlement. You know? Artillery is settlement. Okay, he had that auto loader, you know. But we don't care for that. We don't want Artie to finish our dirty job, you know. So, let's drive forward. And let's kill M3 Stuart. Maybe. Come on. Hi, miss. Where? I want that kill. Please. Oh no, all this dying. Ah, let's shoot in frustration. Let's kill. Okay, so that was that, you know. Nothing special. 710 HP. We stopped that MKA from flanking our guys and doing havoc in base, you know. You saw me waiting for him to go behind bush too, so he wouldn't spotted me. But when he was exiting, he kind of spot me there. But anyway, let's see. Not bad for this kind of MM. So that was that. Let's see your best game in this tank. Okay, only thing better than Panzerjäger 1 is 2 Panzerjägers 1 in platoon, you know. Not sure if I said that correctly or anything. And he has that Klokosh camo, you know. But who is he? He is a Harzwebel. And his platoon mate is Sturek Dvonrek. Maybe they are not Germans, maybe they are Polish. I don't know, but they are in platoon in 2 Panzerjäger 1, you know, and that is epic, you know. Just imagine that firepower and damage, and let's see. So this is your best game in this tank. Thank you, sir. Sorry. And let's see. Okay, M2 light on very bad position. Don't ever go there in first bush. Go in that second bush behind the rock or that knockout tower. So both of those M2 lights, you know, were on wrong side. Well, you can be spotted easier there, and when you are spotted, it is much harder to go back, you know. T2 light, yay, destroy T2 light. Okay, his friend went a little bit too forward. He didn't bother to put some, you know, fire on that M2 shooting at him, so his teammate is dead. But I will pause here just to show you where he should be. Wow, he was completely on open. That is stupid. He should be here in this bush, you know. And that is even better bush than this bush, you know. But okay, let's go back in his view. Okay, bad shot. Okay, Harold Zwiebel. Come on, kill those M2s. You know, those are probably most annoying things in tier 2, you know. Well, in that full range from tier 1 to tier 3. If not most annoying, then, well, in tier 3, yeah, that, okay, let's just concentrate on tier 1 and tier 2, M2 light, you know, it is disaster, you know. It's so annoying to play against that. It is fast, it has a deadly gun and auto gun, and it is also very fast, let's say that. Bouncy fast and nice firepower. And that is why our friend switched to APCR, you know, because M2 light is bouncy. So you want to shoot the APCR on that tank, especially from this distance. Ooh, that was nice shot. Okay. Let's see. He isn't aiming the best, you know. He's a bit too nervous. Or maybe he should, you know, decrease mouse speed in controls. At least in sniper aim, you know. So, in this, you know, view from outside, I have decently fast mouse speed, so I can faster, you know, look around and try to maybe auto lock some of the targets. But in sniper aim, I decrease that speed because I want to be more precise and accurate. And if your mouse is slower in sniper mode, you will, you know, manage to do that easier. So 4 kills for him now, but it is still, you know, even 8-8. T60 pushing up. There is a UC 2 Pounder, you know, Universal Carrier. And that was an epic little, you know, vehicle, to say like that, because some people will not acknowledge that as a tank or fighting vehicle. Ooh, he isn't really the truck, but he is dead. Back to garage for you. And isn't that lovely when you kill M2? That is probably most satisfying thing, you know, if you are not M2 and in M2. Okay, so Okay, you have shot. Okay, D-truck, dead. That is lovely. That was his 6th kill, you know. And 4 tanks, you know, left. So, I guess his buddy can learn something from him now, you know. First, you don't need to be so close because, you know, your guys can spot for you. Second, from this position you can shoot there anyway, and from this position also, if you are a little bit, if you are really in bush, you know, in that bush, not behind bush. So I don't see point for him being 10 meters in front exposed, you know. Well, it is a little bit more than 10 meters, but you are so much more exposed there, and if they win hill like they did, you know, with 8 km/h, you cannot really go in safety, at least not fast. And you will be spotted whenever you fire, and maybe sometimes even if you don't fire on that position from here, depends how good crew they have and you range. So I don't see any point in being there. That is what I wanted to say, because I often see people in that bush, don't go there, it is stupid, you know. Don't go there. This bush is phenomenal, you know. You will park there next to rock. You have you on hill, on those positions on hill. Small, better view than this guy on, you know, incoming tanks from that side. And you have even shots all the way to there. You know. Okay, guy. Panzer 2 spotted. So you can see there even better than from here. I just saying for new people, you know. Okay. I would aim in engine deck, but okay, he had more target, you know, behind. But he killed him eventually, so... Or in the end, I don't know. Is that even correct thing to say eventually for that sentence? Anyway, let's see here. We have 70p, that is like Italian M2 light, you know. Ooh, that is bad. Two of his crew members injured. You know, they are dying now. Luckily he has some amazing medics there. So he managed to repair his guy, well, one of them. Other one needs to wait for this medic kit to cool down. Okay, it is game. So, yeah, drive in dead Tiger 1. That is my idea. Okay, T-60 went there and he stood there for a really long time. Somebody was complaining. Okay, go, you have one shot. I guess he wants to say he is one shot, you know. So who will kill that M2 light, Y-type B or our friend in Panzerjäger 1 with a Kokosh camo? Ooh, this is nasty. Oh, he had shot. This guy is pulling back. Ooh, and yay, he managed to do it all the way, you know, with engaged optics. So it was a little bit tense, you know, especially because his commander is still knockout. But 9 kills, finally we saw one of, you know, really epic games in those epic lower tier tanks. Well, you may say, but he was just sniping, camping, blah blah, it is TD with no armor, that is what TDs do. So let's see post-game data and who did what. Okay, so Zwiebel earned 6,000 rubles, you know, clear, but with premium account without, he would be in big minus, you know, 58 shots fired, 36 on target, and let's see, 11 tanks damage and he killed 9. Pretty good, you know, but I must say that our replay that you watched already is second in damage, third in experience and fourth in frags. So it is pretty good for one recently, you know, played game. Set on experience, 859 stats of experience, 9 kills, 1612 HP of damage. He's first in all of this. And let's see personal score. He got Top Gun, High Caliber, Far Perfect Bruiser and M badge for this tank and this game. There is one guy with a better experience damage and frags of both of us, and he is first in all three of that, but he played against bots and we cannot include that in these reviews. Now let's just hear that final verdict for this tank destroyer. In the end, that question, should you keep this tank or sell it as soon you unlock next one in line? And my answer is, I draw this tank for 1510 times 76% win ratio, some amazing damage ratio and destruction ratio. Here, 1479 maximum experience, 1663 maximum damage, 9 kills. I didn't play it for a really long time until I decided to do review a few days ago, yesterday. So let's see here, awards, 4 scout medals. This tank is crazy, you know. 8 times in a row I survive without damage taken. It is good sniper. Even 2 kamikaze medal in this crap, you know. And 3 Kolobanos medal in this tank. So it was really epic TD. But these days, you know, there is so much tanks that are too fast. So in city, you know, in Himmelsdorf, this tank isn't so good. In my opinion, better invest time and crew maybe in Hetzer, you know, tier 4 tank destroyer. But if you really want, you know, good tier 2 tank destroyer, in my opinion, this is now when we don't have any more T-18 as tank destroyer in tier 2. I think this is a best option for you. So if you really want something like this, then big yes from me for this TD. Hopefully this review was helpful. You know, if you want, you can, you know, like, subscribe if you didn't. You can share also and help me with that. Also to buy my merch, because no merch, no chocolate, no more reviews. Unfortunately, I didn't start recording these medals from start, so I don't have my first one, but let's see some of them. Pobeda means victory, you know, and Poraz means defeat, but we will not see much of them. There you go, you can follow with your eyes damage and kills, you know, in second sheet, so we don't have really time to stay long on each of them, you know, but... you can pause this video also if you need to see something better. So we had a lot of, you know, embedges in this tank, and it wasn't easy to get embedge in this tank or TD, trust me, it was pretty hard. But now, yeah, it is time to say goodbye to this TD. Maybe I will put this crew in Hetzer, who knows, we'll see, are they compatible, you know. So there is even draws, and that is now start, okay. Okay, thank you for watching, and see ya.